1, 2, 1, 2. from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts, but I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hand my body over so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It is not jealous. It is not pompous. It is not inflated. It is not rude. It does not seek its own interest. It is not quick-tempered. It does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. The word of the Lord.
Said to his disciples, "You are the salt of the earth, but if salt loses its taste, with what can it be seasoned? It is no longer good for anything but to be thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city set on a mountain cannot be hidden, nor do they light a lamp and then put it under a bushel basket. It is set on a lampstand, where it gives light to all in the house. Just so, your light must shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your heavenly Father." The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. Again, we extend a warm welcome to everyone here today, as we are very happy and grateful to share in this moment with Tim and Rachel as they begin their new life together. Tim refreshed my memory that you both work in a telemarketing company and that you had a car accident and he rescued you from a burning car. So you cannot say no to him asking you for a date. So he was happy that he met you and God placed you in his life. And we're grateful to you for your steps that you have taken with marriage preparation. We come here to pray for you today as you open a new door, the new door of marriage together in your relationship. And all of us can think about doors for a moment. You open the doors of this church building. You open the doors to your car after Mass. We all open doors to our houses, our schools, our places at work, and many other places as well. Good practice for all of us when we physically open a door is to pray, may I open the doors of my heart to Jesus. May I open the doors of my heart to the people in this room. Try it. It will dramatically change the atmosphere for the better. You can summarize life by saying it's about opening our hearts to Christ and opening our hearts to one another. We thank all those who opened the doors of their hearts to be here today, to this wedding, in some way, shape, or form, figuratively speaking. You opened the doors of your hearts to be here today, sharing the happiness of Tim and Rachel. Pope Francis gave three words as a starting point for simple practices of strengthening our relationships. The three words are please, thanks, and sorry. Please, practice making your needs known to God and to one another. Thanks, in our relationships, express gratitude and appreciation. Sorry, let us practice reconciliation with one another and with God. We acknowledge our weaknesses and our brokenness. We trust that God, our spouse, our family members will forgive us. There's a story I often tell at weddings. It is about a young boy with a stuttering problem that was growing up on an alley. One day, a social worker pulled up in a beautiful brand new car, and the little boy with the stuttering problem asked the social worker, who gave you that car? The social worker said, my brother, he gave me that car. The little boy with the stuttering problem started to say, I wish I could. And the social worker interrupted the boy and said, son, I know what you're trying to say. You're trying to say, I wish I could have a brother like that. I wish I could have a brother who would give me a beautiful brand new car. And the little boy said, no, I wish I could be a brother like that. Today, Tim and Rachel promise to be the very best for one another. Our second reading calls us to do what is best for the other person. In marriage, both persons are called to mutual self-giving and service. If I were to utilize the insight of St. Paul and paraphrase the words of John F. Kennedy, I would say to him, ask not so much what your wife can do for you, but what you can do for your wife. And I would say to Rachel, ask not so much what your husband can do for you, but what you can do for your husband. For it is in seeking each other's happiness that you will become happy. Real love can only be kept if it is given away. Tim, you could ask yourself, how can I be a good husband? How can I be a good father? How can I do all the things expected of me? And Rachel, you can ask yourself, how can I be a good wife? How can I be a good mother? How can I do all the things expected of me? The answer is alone, by yourself. You cannot. But think in these terms, together with Christ, we can make it. If you center your lives in Christ, follow his example, and pray for his guidance, you will have a beautiful marriage. The symbol of Christian marriage, two rings on a cross. The understanding is that it takes three persons to make a good marriage. Man, a woman, and Christ. You wear special clothes today to signify this is a special day. In one of his letters, St. Paul rights. Above all, hold yourselves in the love of Christ. Hopefully today you will put on something that you will not take off. Above all, hold yourselves with the love of Christ for one another. Now I will invite the bride and groom to come before the altar here and stand facing the congregation, and the best man and maid of honor. Our response to these prayers will be, Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for Tim and Rachel, for their well-being as a couple, and as a family. For this we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Pray for the relatives and friends who are here today and for those who may be watching this wedding being live streamed. We ask God's blessing on you and are happy that you are with us in spirit to share in this special day with Rachel and Tim. May God bless you. Let us pray to the Lord. We remember in a special way all your deceased relatives and friends who could not be here physically today, but are with us in spirit and smiling down upon us from heaven. For them, we pray to the Lord. Lord Jesus, who are present in our midst, as Tim and Rachel seal their union, accept our prayer and fill us with your Holy Spirit, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Please be seated. Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, we pray, O Lord, the offering made on this happy occasion of the sealing of the sacred bond of marriage. And just as your goodness is its origin, may your providence guide its course through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you willed that the human race, created by the gift of your goodness, should be raised to such high dignity that in the union of husband and wife, you might bestow a true image of your love for those you created out of charity, you call to the law of charity without ceasing, and grant them a share in your eternal charity, and so the sacrament of holy matrimony. as the abiding sign of your own love, consecrates the love of man and woman through Christ our Lord. Through him, with the angels and all the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and
profess your
resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking in the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, and all the clergy. And again, in a special way, we remember all your loved ones who have died, who are with us in spirit today. We ask God's blessings on them as they share in this special day and their place in heaven. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, recite the Our Father and the prayer afterwards. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. This part of the Mass we pray for deliverance from evil. We ask God to set you free today from whatever may be troubling your hearts. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. My friends, may the peace of the Lord be with you always. And during this time of COVID-19, we physically omit the sign of peace, so we will sing the Lamb of God. After the bride and groom have received Holy Communion and the servers will form a single file line in the middle aisle, and those of us who are Catholic can receive our Lord in Holy Communion. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. And those of us in the congregation can stand. Let us humbly invoke by our prayers, dear brothers and sisters, God's blessing upon this bride and groom, that in his kingdom he may favor with his help those on whom he has bestowed the sacrament of matrimony. Holy Father, maker of the whole world, who created man and woman in your own image, and will that their union be crowned with your blessing, we humbly beseech you for these your servants who are joined today at the sacrament of matrimony. May your abundant blessing, Lord, come down upon your bride, Rachel, and upon our groom, Tim, her companion for life. And may the power of your Holy Spirit set their hearts aflame from on high, so that living out together the gift of matrimony, they may adorn their family with children and enrich your church. In happiness, may they praise you, O Lord. In sorrow, may they seek you out. And may they have the joy of your presence to assist them in their toil and to know that you are there to comfort them in their need. Let them pray to you in the Holy Assembly and bear witness to you in the world. And after a happy old age together with the circle of their friends that surround them, may they come to the kingdom of heaven through Christ our Lord. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that the power of the sacrament we have received may find growth in these your servants, and that the effects of the sacrifice which we have offered may be felt by us all. We ask this through Christ our Lord. We ask God's blessing on everybody here. The Lord be with you. May the Lord Jesus, who graced the marriage at Cana by his presence, bless you and your loved ones. May he who loved the church to the end unceasingly pour out his love into your hearts. May the Lord grant that very witness through faith in his resurrection, you may awake with joy the blessed hope to come. And may Almighty God bless all of you who are gathered here in a special way, the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.